A groundbreaking discovery from UC Berkeley researchers is shedding new light on the link between diet and obesity. We all know the joy of a salty French fry or a delicious burger, but scientists now say high-fat diets may reduce the pleasure of eating in those with obesity, but the data could open doors to better treatments. And so this morning, we welcome Dr. Stéphane Lamel. He is an associate professor of neurobiology and postdoctoral scholar Netta Gazit-Shimoni. Thank you both for being with us this morning. We appreciate it.
Hello, good morning. Thanks for having us.
Of course. Explain, first of all, where did the idea from this research come from?
So, for me, when I started studying obesity, I was expecting in mice, when you put them on high-fat diet, that we're going to see some kind of like food addiction. They're going to be so eager to eat these hedonic high-caloric food. And then I saw a very unusual phenomena where they actually have reduced drive for hedonic foods in specific situations. And while we found that this is something people have seen in the past, no one actually went into understanding how does this make sense and what is the mechanism.
And so what ultimately did you find was the cause of this change in desire?
Yes, what we found is we all know that there's a brain transmitter that we have, it's called dopamine. But we found there's a molecule that actually regulates dopamine. Dopamine is very important for reward and pleasure. But this molecule that we identified, it's called neurotensin, is actually diminished. There's a reduction in neurotensin. And we found when we bring this neurotensin level back in the brain, then either by changing the diet or by artificially changing neurotensin levels in the brain, this actually benefited weight loss. So this sounds paradoxically, because we all think that always obesity is driven by excessive pleasure, or seeking out pleasure, mm-hmm. but our results suggest that it's actually the opposite. And what we are proposing is a radical new approach that bringing back the pleasure into our brain, that might be an important new approach for treating obesity.
That is incredibly interesting, and one of the reasons why I thought it was so important to talk to you about this research. Obviously, you were doing this test in mice. How likely do you think it will be, you know, being able to be used in humans, and when could we possibly even see that happen?
Yeah, you know that a lot of discoveries we made were actually made in mouse. If you think about these new superstar medicines, GLP-1s, they have been actually in part discovered in mice. So the mechanism we find are actually really, really important in mouse. And if you think about a lot of the evolutionary brain circuits between mice and humans that are important for pleasure, reward, and motivation, they're actually conserved. We find them in both in humans and mice. So we think that there's actually a very high chance that ultimately in a few years our research might translate into humans.
I think that is very encouraging for a lot of people this morning to hear that this is very possible in the very near future. Thank you both for joining us this morning. And of course, we're going to put this information on our website so our viewers can learn more about your research and of course, follow its developments.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.